And he didn't come for a woman. And he believed in God himself. That's why he fights so hard to get you not to believe. He was in heaven. He experienced the glory. He experienced the power. That's why he fights so hard to get you not to believe in the word. So I challenge you today, whatever you're going through, give it a day. And the day is today. It will always be this day.
Amen.
This day. No more tolerating. We spend half our life tolerating things. When all you had to do was speak to it.
That's right.
You keep tolerating. And instead of applying the word works. But the problem is we're not applying it. You apply it one day and you may feel a little better. And then you go back to doing what you was doing. See, like my sister said, you can't have no plan B when it comes to the things of God.
That's right.
It's not enough because the word of God works. It works. He wants you to be prosperous. He wants you to have the desires of your heart. He wants you to have nice things. You desire nice cars, nice house, whatever it is you desire, he wants to give it to you. Because that's the type of God we serve. He wants to be blessed and highly favored. But if you always going through, if you always burdened down, if you always worrying about the cares and the lust of this world, how God gonna use you?
That's right.
He was teaching the disciples when they was in the ship, he was teaching them, all you need is me. That's all you need. I'm everything you need. And in me, you'll be able to accomplish everything you wanted to accomplish. But we don't take the prescription long enough. You can't go to the gym one day and then the next day look in the mirror and think you don't have abs.
That's right.
It don't work that way. It's a process. And sometimes when you're going through a storm, sometimes storms can be self-inflicted. And sometimes storms can be just necessary to get you to the next level where God intended for you to go. So some storms are necessary to give that extra boost. And some storms are brought on by people. People that you're trying to hold on for too long. That you know you should have been cutting them off. Hallelujah. You have your Bible. Go to me the book of Luke. And I'm going to start at verse 33. Luke chapter 22, verse 33, it says, and he said unto them, Lord, I am ready to go with thee, both into prison and to death. And he said, I tell thee, Peter, the cock shall crow this day, believe that thou shalt deny me three times that thou knowest me. And here is Peter. You know, you have people say, oh, man, I'll be with you forever. Man, I'm down with you. And then the first time you go through or the first time you have a disagreement, then it's something else. That's why I always tell people, be careful when you say, God told me to do it. Because one thing about it, God's not going to tell you to do a half job, and then God's not going to change his mind because you're uncomfortable. See, a lot of times when people say, God tell them to do something, when they get uncomfortable, now God didn't tell them to do it. Now they want to leave. But sometimes the uncomfortable, you being uncomfortable is your benefit. Because sometimes you being uncomfortable, it's going to push you. Like I said all the time, God allow you to be uncomfortable only to make you comfortable. So sometimes when you're uncomfortable, God is breaking you. He's making you. I remember when I was at the lowest point in my life, I was uncomfortable. But God was pushing me into my destiny, pushing me into my purpose. So Peter told me, he told Peter, he said, the cock shall crow this day. Not this day, but you're going to deny me three times. And he said unto him, when I sent you without purse and strip and shoes, let ye anything. And they said nothing. So when Jesus called his disciples, he told them, don't take anything with you. Because he was teaching them a valuable lesson. If you have Jesus, if you have me, you have everything you need. He was telling them the three things that that is in our economic system. Money, clothes and food. He said, don't take none of these things with you. And he said, when you did take none of these things, he said, did you lack anything? And they said nothing. So he was showing them, as long as you have me in your life, you will have everything you need.
Come
and
on now.
In the midst of a storm, it's vital that you take Jesus with you. Because if you take Jesus with you, it's going to make it just that much easier. None of us are immune to storms. But it's who you connect it to that makes the difference. Because one thing about it, like I said all the time, if you're going through, you're going through. But when you go through connected to Jesus Christ, when you get through, you're going to look back and say, man, I came a long way. And you're going to look back and say, how did I come that far? And you can't do nothing but give Jesus Christ all the glory and all that is due to his name. Who are you connected to? And when you connect to Jesus Christ, you can't do nothing but win, because there's no losing in our God.
That's right. Amen.
It's a fail-proof system. Verse 36. Then said unto them, but now that have purse, let them take it, and likewise his shrimp, and he have sword, let him sell his garment and buy one. For I say unto you that it is written, must yet be accomplished in me. And he was breaking among the transgressors, for the things concerning me have an end. Verse 38. And they said, Lord, behold, here are two swords. And he said to them, it is enough. Verse 39. And he came out and went as he wanted, to the Mount of Olives, and his disciples also followed him. And when he was at the place, he said unto them, pray ye that he enter not into temptation. Verse 41. And he was withdrawn from them about a stone cast, and he kneeled down and prayed, saying, Father, if it be willing, remove this cup from me. Nevertheless, not my will, but thy will be done. So even in the midst of Jesus' storm, when Jesus knew he was about to be crucified, he said, Father God, if it be your will, remove this cup from me. But then he said, nevertheless, because he had us on his mind. He said, I'm going through this because I'm going to redeem these people from hell. I'm going to redeem these people from sickness. I'm going to redeem them from anything that comes against them. So he said, it's not my will. So sometimes you got to look yourself in the mirror and you got to say, Father God, I know I'm going through, but not my will, but your will. Me going through this will benefit somebody else. A lot of times what we go through is not for us, it's for somebody else. The Bible says we overcome by the word of our testimony. That's how we encourage each other. We encourage each other by saying, look, I've been through the same thing you went through. That's how I'm telling you, you can get through. I'm not telling you something I've seen on TV. I'm not telling you I heard something that somebody else said. I've been through the same thing that you went through, and I know you're going to come out victorious. Amen. I know you're going to come out on top.
Yes.
Back in the Bible, when King Nebuchadnezzar, he made that golden image, and he told Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, they had to bow down and worship it. They said, King, even if God don't do it, we're not going to bow down and worship you. We're not going to serve you even if God don't do it. But we know that God is not a respected person. We know that God is not a man that he should lie. He's going to do
right.
it.
Amen.
Because if you're faithful to God, he's faithful to you. And even when you're not faithful to God, he's still faithful to you. His word cannot change. God sent his only begotten son, unique, one of a kind, faultless, blameless, to die on our behalf. And the only requirement is for you to believe that he can do what his word says he can do.
Amen.
But we've been conditioned and trained to believe everything else. This guy at my job say, we all going to hell. I said, no, speak for yourself, partner. I ain't going to hell.
That's right.
Well, he said, I'm going to hell. I said, okay, that's fine with you. But you think you want to go.
Right.
Oh, it's hell or not. That hell on earth is hell and hell.
That's right.
It's not hell on earth. And your people worries on how they think. Because their mind has not been renewed.
That's right.
Hallelujah. Verse 43. He says, and there appeared an angel unto him from heaven, strengthening him. And being in agony, he prayed more earnestly, and his sweat was as great drops of blood falling down to the ground. And when he rose up from prayer, he was come to his disciples, and he found them sleeping from sorrow. And he said to them, why sleep ye? Rise and pray, lest thou enter into temptation. Verse 47. And while he yet spake, behold, a multitude, and he that was called Judas, one of his 12, went before him and drew near unto Jesus and kissed him. Verse 48. But Jesus said to him, Judas betrayeth thy son of man with a kiss. Verse 49. When they which were about him saw what would follow, they said to him, Lord, shall we smite with the sword? And one of them smote the servant of the high priest and cut his ear off. Jesus answered and said, suffer ye this far, and touched him his ear, and he healed him.
Wow.
So even in the midst of Jesus' storm, even in the midst of his tribulation, even in the midst of his trial, even in the midst of his storm, it was the most darkest, he still was doing what God called him to do. So while we go through, while we be conditioned to draw back, when you're going through, that's the time that you should run to God even more. But we've been conditioned, we've been trained, when we go through to pull back from God. God. That's like if you hear a storm coming, you go cut your own power off. God is power. That's our source of power. That's our source of life. So when you're going through, why you disconnect from the only one that's going to help you, the only one that's going to deliver you, the only one that's able to change your situation? You disconnect from him. You draw back from God like it's hurting God. But it's hurting you.
Jesus.
One word from God will change your life. One word from God will change your situation.
Amen.
But you got to be plugged in. You got to be connected to get power.
Amen.
But when we're going through, we want to draw back from God. And God said, my daughter, my son, I love you unconditionally. I know what you're going through. I know it's hard. I know it's rough. But I'm with you.
Thank you, Lord. Every step of the way.
And when you come out of it, it's going to be some good that come out of it. The Bible says in all things, give thanks. In all things, give thanks. In all things, give thanks. A lot of times we walk around complaining about things, but our life can be so much, much worse than what it is. In all things, give thanks. Everybody have a sad story. Everybody's going through something. We all got issues. We all need Jesus. We all. But in the midst of Jesus' battle, he was still doing what he was called to do. He healed the person that was coming to take him to kill him.
Amen.
He healed them.
Amen.
Because he was love. And the Bible says love covers a multitude of sins.
He didn't treat Peter no different.
He didn't treat Judas no different. Because Judas and Peter, they played their part.
Amen.
They had to do it.
Amen.
But Jesus loved them the same. He knew Judas was going to betray them. He knew Peter was going to deny, because he asked Peter, he said, Peter, do you love me? He said, Father, you know I love you. Peter, do you love me? He said, Father, you know I love you. Peter, do you love me? Because he knew Peter was going to deny three times. So he asked Peter, do you love me three times?
Mm-hmm.
He knew Judas was going to betray him with a kiss. But he didn't tell Judas, you can't go with me. He didn't tell Peter, you can't go with me.
Yes.
He still loved on him.
Yes.
He still loved on him. So when you're going through and your friends start to fall away, when you're going through, when the friends told you that they'll be with you to the end, they're the first ones to leave. The people who do the less expect the most.
Yes.
The people who don't bring nothing to the table always want to eat first. Hallelujah.
Ooh, that's good. Yes. That's good.
But when you got Jesus, none of that matters.
None of it.
You still love on him.
Thank you, Lord.
But you just got love from a distance.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Verse 53, it says, when I was daily with you in the temple, you stretched forth no hands against me. But this is your hour and the power of darkness. They took him and led him and brought him into the high priest's house. And Peter followed afar off. Verse 55. And when they had kindled a fire in the midst of the hall, were sat down together, Peter sat down among them. But a certain maid beheld him as he sat by the fire, and earnestly looked upon him and said, this man was also with him. And he denied him, saying, woman, I know him not. And after a little while, another saw him and said, thou art also of them. And Peter said, man, I am not. Verse 59, and about the space of an hour, after another confidently affirmed, saying of a truth, this fellow also was with him, for he is a Galilean. And Peter said, man, I know not what thou sayest. And immediately, while he yet spake, the cock crowed. And the Lord turned and looked upon Peter, and Peter remembered the word of the Lord, how he had said unto him, before the cock crow, thou shalt deny me three times.
Mm-hmm.
It says, and Peter went out and wept bitterly, and the man that held Jesus mocked him and smote him.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah. And Jesus went through all that for us.
Yes.
Not for us to live a subpar life. Not for us to live an average life, but for us to dominate life on purpose. For us to walk into our breakthrough on purpose. When things happen out, like, it's not by coincidence. It's not by chance or by luck or fortune. It's because we apply what we believe. When you go to school and you do your work, they didn't give you your degree. You earned your degree by doing the work to get your degree. So meanwhile, the thing, the doing the work in the body of Christ, all it is believing and speaking.
That's right, man.
Believing and speaking. You have to open your mouth and declare what you want to see. Hallelujah. John 15 and 7, it says, whatever you ask in my will, believing. It didn't say doing everything right. It didn't say reading the Bible for 8 hours a day, praying for 10 hours a day. It just said believing. Can you believe that God will do it? Can you believe that he's able?
Yes.
But just think of everything else we believe. You believe the sun gonna come up every single day. You don't question that. And that's by the word of God. God said, let there be light. And the sun come up every day. Haven't missed a day since I've been living. It haven't missed a day. And that same authority, he gave it to us. You can use that authority. He gave it to you. But we just allow the authority that Jesus Christ gave us to use for us. We just put it on the shelf. Mm-hmm. We just sit it down. Well, God know my needs. Mm-hmm. Yeah, he know your needs. And you know you have you need groceries. But if you don't go to Walmart, Walmart not just gonna come knock on your door and put the groceries in the refrigerator. You got to go get them.
That's right.
Amen.
You got to go get them. So God said, I've provided everything you need for you. What you waiting on to go get it? You don't have to get my approval for something I already gave you. You don't have to get my approval to be blessed. You don't have to get my approval to be healed. You don't have to get my approval to have a successful business. I already gave it to you. All you have to do is speak it and walk into it.
Amen.
Lauren is now 3. I'm not going to chew Lauren food up and feed it to her too. She can chew her own food up. God has said, he already said he's going to bless you. He's not going to go get the money and put it in your pocket.
That's right.
He's not going to go get the house and give you the keys. He said the house is out there. You just got to find the keys. The car is out there. You got to get the keys. The successful business is out there. Why we think we can't be blessed? Why? We just sit back and watch everybody else. And then you say, one day I'm going to have that. No, you're not going to have it if you say it one day.
This day.
And this day, Father God, declare
yes.
that everybody in this room today, Father God, every storm that they are facing, Father God, is over right now in the
yes.
mighty name of Jesus. I thank you, Father God, this day that they are blessed and highly favored. Father God, I thank you this day that any addiction, anything that try to attach itself to them is over this day. This day, Father God, we bind up all the tricks, the traps, the snare of the enemy right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Father God, your word said whatever we bound in heaven is already bound on earth. And whatever we loose in heaven is already loose on earth. So, Father God, this day, we bind up all the plots, the plans of Satan right now in the mighty name of Jesus. We bind up all sickness and disease known unto man. We bind up insufficiency. We bind up low self-esteem. We bind up depression. We bind up mental illness. We bind up high blood pressure. We bind up anything that opposes your word, Father God. And this day, Father God, we lose healing. We lose deliverance.
Yes.
We lose your yoke-destroying power. We lose the blessing in every arena of our life. We lose our hands, our anointing to gather wealth. This day, Father God, no weapon formed against us shall prosper. We thank you, Father God, that we are healed from the crown of our head to the sole of our feet. This day, Father God, we thank you that every tissue, every organ in our body which you created it already in. This day, Father God, we will no longer tolerate sickness. We will no tolerate insufficiency. We will not tolerate anything, Father God, that causes distraction or a hindrance to our life. This day, Father God, we don't care what it looks like. We
yes. shout
to you, Father God. We thank you, Father God, every day that our feet hit the ground, that something good will take place in our life. We thank you, Father God, this day,
this
that your favor goes before us in every situation, in every circumstance, opening up doors, rearranging, and changing things in our life. This day, Father God, we will not tolerate anything that comes from Satan, Father God, because he is eternally defeated in the mighty name of Jesus. Father God, this day, we declare that we're victorious, and we will not look back on our past. We will not look back on anything that the enemy told us we can't do when Satan tried to remind us of our future. future. We will remind him of his, remind him of our past. We will remind him of his future, and that's in hell. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father God. Thank you, Father God. Hallelujah. I'm telling y'all. We win. Hallelujah, Father God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father God. No more settling. No more accepted average. Hallelujah. No more tolerating what God told us to speak to. Hallelujah. Anything that causes interference to your life, anything that opposes the word of God, anything that hinders you from getting what God told you can have, it got to go this day. Hallelujah. We don't allow the enemy to rob us far too much. We don't allow the enemy to take so much of our life. And we got the authority. We got the dominion. So this day, everything that irritated you, everything that aggravated you, everything that agitated you, it's over. No more. No more. But you got to get mad enough at your situation that you actually do something about it. The devil is an intruder. He's not welcome in our homes. He's not welcome in our kids. We got to stop tolerating that stuff. Hallelujah. Amen. The only power the enemy have is the power that we give him. That's what the Bible tells us. Submit yourself unto God and resist the devil.
Amen.
And he will flee.
Yes. Yes.
Father God, we thank you that great is the peace of our children.
Yes.
For they are taught of the Lord.
Yes.
So Father God, we don't care what it looks like. We know that we are multi-millionaires.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
No less. No insufficiency. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We're supposed to be dominating on purpose every single day.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Thank you.
And when they was taking Jesus to be crucified, they were spitting on him. They was beating him. But he was going through all that for us.
That's right.
All he had to do was say one word, and the angels would have came.
That's right.
And then when he got on the cross, it was a thief and a robber. And one of them said, if you are who you say you are, save me. And he said, this day, you will be with me in paradise. Jesus said, this day. He didn't tell the guy next week. He said, this day, you will be with me in paradise. And he hung his head and he said, it is finished. He told his storm that it is finished. Jesus said, they didn't take his life, he gave it up.
Amen.
And he said, it is finished. I did everything I needed to do for us to be successful on this earth. He died for us. And we live in any kind of way of living average, that's an injustice to Jesus. And the cross is symbolized the way he died at, where he laid his life at. But when we look at the cross, we don't value the cross. If you go to New York where the Twin Towers got knocked down, I guarantee you there's not a day go by that it's not somebody low and mourning and just standing there crying where they lost them. You go to Hawaii, you go to Pearl Harbor. That happened in what, the 40s or 50s. But every single day there's somebody there mourning the loss of their loved ones. That's a memorial. But when we look at the cross, we just look at it as a piece of wood.
Mm.
No, it's not a piece of wood. The cross symbolizes where your life was changed forever.
Yeah.
Your life was changed forever on the cross. So when you look at the cross, you got the value of the cross. It's not just a piece of wood, but it's where you gain everything that you would need to dominate this earth.
Yes, God.
On purpose.
Hallelujah.
God didn't die for us to barely make it.
Right.
He died for us to live this life in the abundance,
right,
to the full,
yes,
to the overflow.
Amen.
And it's an injustice to him if we live any other kind of way. But you got to know what you have a right to. I mean, we sometimes we just go through life casually. We just go through life and then you look back 20 years in the past and you worse than what you was. If you still the same Since high school, something wrong.
Something's wrong. Yeah, that's right.
Something
that's
wrong.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Growth.
Yep.
And at the end of the day, people put so much focus on the material things. But if you don't have Jesus Christ, the material things don't mean nothing.
Right. Amen.
But he's so good. He want to give you the desires of your heart. There's nothing wrong. I like nice things. That's him. I desire nice things. There's nothing wrong with that. And he said he'd give you the desires of your heart, so it's whatever you desire. But I tell you today, give your storm an expiration day. And that day is today.
Amen.
And once you give it to God, you just continue to thank him.
Yes.
And keep pushing forward.
That's right.
Or keep applying the word. Because you apply what you believe. If you say you believe the word, if you believe in the name of Jesus, when adversity hit, when certain situations and circumstances hit, that's the first thing you're going to do is go to the word. The word of God should be our last resort. See, sometimes we go with all our options, and then when everything else fails, we come back to the one that's going to help us the first time.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
With no screens and tasks, no guidelines, no stipulations.
Yep.
That's his job. He want to help you. He want to see you blessed. But do you want to see you blessed?
Amen.
That's the key.
Amen.
Because if you want to see yourself blessed, you apply the word to your life.
Right.
You apply the word to your situation. We ain't tolerate this stuff no more. What you want to do? Are you comfortable living average? Are you comfortable barely making it? Comfortable living paycheck to paycheck? What's comfortable about that? But you have everything you need right here to change your life. All you got to do is open up your mouth and declare what you want to see.
Amen.
When the last time have you told your storm? When the last time you spoke to it? When the last time you spoke to your bills? When the last time you declared total prosperity or healing on your body? Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's like Tay said before, you go to the doctor and you were diagnosed with cancer, and the doctor give you a clean bill of health, and you tell the doctor, I want the cancer back. That's how we do all the time. We return back to the bondage. God delivered you out of a situation,
right,
but you keep returning to the same situation that he delivered you from. And that's like, if don't mean to be like, if you throw up, and then you go eat what you threw up. Come on. Today is the last day you'll go through.
Hallelujah.
Today is the last day you'll have any addiction.
Amen.
Today is the last day you will lack anything.
This
day, this is your turning point. But do you believe it? When you walk out here today, go and dominate. Go get everything the devil told you couldn't have.
Amen.
Told you didn't have a right to. Go get it. And prove him wrong. Amen?
Amen. Amen.